Now maybe we can try to tie everything that we've done together as far as these methods and pre-built existing methods in Java. And one of the things that I see quite a bit as a teacher is that when students submit papers these days, they submit them in many cases as if they were a text message. There's no punctuation, there's kind of no formality, no capitalization. It really isn't kind of interesting from that perspective to see that many papers come in that way, and it's in a lot of ways kind of sad that we're losing our great writing skills due to just how people kind of communicate these days. But I guess what I was thinking is maybe we could write a little program that goes in and checks for punctuation. Maybe you can use this program. Anyway, so this program will go in and just check to see if there's a capital letter at the beginning of each sentence and some sort of punctuation at the end of the sentence. Does that sound okay? So kind of what I'm thinking is as we look at how to do this, maybe we could just put together a little bit of pseudocode that will kind of just give us an idea of how we want to do this. So we're going to have the user enter a sentence. So maybe that would kind of be the first step. So user enters a sentence. Okay. Once we have that sentence, what I'm kind of thinking is let's go ahead and check that first letter. So look at the first letter. Okay. And then if the first letter is lowercase, then we can make the first letter uppercase. Okay. So pretty simple. We're going to check that first character, see if it's a lowercase, and if it is, then we're going to make it an uppercase. So we capitalize the beginning of each sentence, right? This is a very basic grammatical rule. So then what are we going to do next? Well, that's the kind of the beginning of the sentence is making sure there's an uppercase in the first letter, and then at the end of the sentence we need to check to make sure there's a punctuation. So then we want to look at the last letter. When I say letter, that's probably not the best way of saying that. We want to look at the first character and we want to look at the last character. Okay, when we've got the last character, we want to check and see is well, not is, but we have to do it kind of in conditional statements. So we'll say if the last character is not, and then what is it going to be? Well, a period is legal. Question mark. What else? Exclamation point. What else can we end a sentence with? Is there anything else? I mean, if it's a true sentence, I guess I was going to say technically maybe you could have semicolon or even colon. But we'll just stick with one of those three. How about that? So the three kind of basic ways of ending the sentence: a period, a question mark, or an exclamation point. So if it's not one of those three, then we have to make a determination of what it is. And we could get kind of tricky and say, and that might be kind of fun. If what does the word begin with? Well, if it begins with a one of the key question mark words, where, why, what, who, when, but we won't get into that complicated of a program. We'll just keep it pretty simple. So if the last character is not one of those things, then we will make the last character one. I guess we'll probably make it a period. That's kind of the default, right? And then we can ask the user to enter another sentence or press Q to quit. Okay, so I'm kind of thinking of doing this inside a loop. What does that mean? That means that all of this well, let's do this. I'll say instead of user enters a sentence, I'll say ask the user to enter a sentence. And that means that every time the user has entered a sentence, we want to go through all these steps again. Okay? And that means it's going to that's going to happen in a loop. And so I'll come in and indent all this because it's going to go inside this loop. And then we'll have our loop. Now, do we want to do this at least once? Yes. Do we know how many times the user is going to want to enter another sentence? No, we don't know. So this is going to be an indefinite loop with a post test, right? We're going to test after. We're going to keep doing this while what? Well, we're going to keep doing it while the user didn't enter a queue. As soon as they enter a queue, then we're going to quit. But as long as they didn't enter a queue, we're going to keep checking the sentence. Okay? So this is kind of just the rough layout, the pseudocode, the algorithm for, I guess we ought to print the correct sentence at some point. So probably ought to do that before this. So print the correct sentence, corrected sentence. And then we can ask them to enter another sentence or press Q to quit. And this is kind of, the rough layout, the algorithm, the pseudocode for this program. Okay? All right, so let's go ahead now and translate that to Java. So I'll go ahead and create a new Java file. And I'll call this public class grammar fun. Public static void string args. Okay, so back to what we need to do. Now, the very first thing we have the user do is to enter a sentence. All right, and so in order for them to be able to enter data, we need to go and import the java.util.scanner. And then we'll need to build an instance of a scanner. So scanner in equals new scanner system.in. Okay, so the scanner's built. And then we're going to need to sort someplace to store the sentence that they enter. So I'm going to say string user sentence, I'll call it, and set it equal to blank, and maybe just a little note here to say this is the how do I say it? What's the opposite of corrected? This is the uncorrected, untampered. This is the original sentence. How about we say that? Okay. And then I'm going to create a second variable to be the new sentence. Okay. So this is going to be the corrected sentence. Sentence with grammatical corrections. Okay, something like that. Okay, so I've got those couple of variables. Let's see if there's any others that I need. Because I'm going to be looking at one character, I like to kind of create a little variable, a char type variable, and just call it temp or something like that, just to hold a character for a minute. Okay, and a lot of times when we create a little temp char, we can call it C or CH. And so maybe I'll just call it CH and set it equal to blank to begin with. Okay, and I can even put here this is a temp character holder. All right, so I've got those things. Let's look at what else I might need. I think we're probably okay. We might discover that we need some more variables, and that's fine. But so let's go in and ask them. So the very first thing we do is ask the user to enter a sentence, right? So ask, get sentence from the user. Okay, so system.out.println, please enter a sentence. Okay, and now what do we do next? Well, we're going to come into this do while loop. So I'll start my do while loop, check sentence, correct any errors, and allow user to enter again. Okay. So I have a do here. I'll come down here, while something. And the while something is going to be while the users, what they've entered is not a queue, right? Well, that means I got to get the user input. And actually, I need to get it right here first. So I'm going to say user sentence equals in dot next line. So we're going to read in the line, store it in the user sentence variable. And then down here at the bottom of the loop, after the user's after all of this checking, then when we get down to the very bottom, we can allow user to quit or enter another sentence to be corrected, something like that. Okay, and so we say system.out.println, and notice I've skipped to the bottom here, but it's because I like to build these things kind of from the inside out. I want to have my while in place and be able to make sure that works even before I go through and do any of the other checking. So system.out.println, and I'll say enter another sentence or press Q to quit, okay? And then I can read in their input. So user sentence is going to be equal to in.nextLine. And now I can check to see, while what? Well, while what they entered is not a queue. So how do I say that in Java? Well, when I'm dealing with strings, then I need to use the dot equals rather than the equals equals, right? So I need to say while the user sentence dot equals a queue, and then do the opposite. Okay, I need to put a not out in the front. So while it's not the situation that the user sentence equals a queue, then we're going to keep doing this. And this only will get us, notice if I run this now, this should work. So let me try saving this, compiling it, and then running it. And so we're going to enter a sentence, and we'll say, doesn't matter, blah. And then it says enter another sentence or press Q to quit. If I say blah again, it will keep going. And as soon as I press a Q, then we quit. Okay, because we only keep doing this while it's not the situation that the user entered a Q. The problem is, what if I enter a lowercase, well, let me do blah again. And what if I enter a lowercase Q here? Well, it'll keep going because Q and lowercase Q are two different things. And so I might want to use here the equals ignore case. And that way, when I run the program now, blah, I can enter a lowercase q and it will quit as well. All right, we'll pause there for a second and continue on in the next video with the actual guts of checking the sentence. But this is the basic structure for getting the sentence and then continuing if the user wants to continue with that do while loop. All right, okay. Spencer out.